Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. In the last video, we saw that SpaceX was standing down from the Hakuto R launch and planning to launch on Thursday. However, SpaceX also posted a tweet on Wednesday that they were standing down again. It said, after further inspections of the launch vehicle and data review, we are standing down from tomorrow's launch of iSpace Inc.'s Hakuto R Mission 1. A new target launch date will be shared once confirmed. Jeff Faust recently posted a tweet about Starlink Gen 2 receiving some FCC approval. It says, the FCC has granted partial approval to SpaceX for Starlink Gen 2, allowing it to deploy up to 7,500 satellites of requested 29,988. We defer action on the remainder of SpaceX's application at this time. Somebody posted something cool on Reddit. It says, Dragon 1 capsule C-113 was officially donated to Chicago's Museum of Science and Industry in Chicago today. C-113 traveled to the ISS twice during the CRS-12 and CRS-17 missions. It will be put on display in the museum this coming spring. SpaceX added a page to their website for something called Starship. It says, Starship leverages SpaceX's Starlink technology and launch capability to support national security efforts. While Starlink is designed for consumer and commercial use, Starship is designed for government use with an initial focus on three areas. There was an article about a launch that's hopefully coming up soon. It says, OneWeb said SpaceX is slated to launch 40 of its satellites as early as December 6 to complete almost 80% of its low Earth orbit broadband constellation. Currently, there is a no earlier date for the launch of the Hakuto R mission on Tuesday, December 6th. However, as we just found out, there is also another mission with a no earlier date of December 6th for the OneWeb launch. The OneWeb 15 mission is currently scheduled for liftoff on Tuesday 6th at 10:37pm UTC or 5:37pm EST. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. Here's a view of the orbital launch mount after the static fire as engineers inspect and work on the mount. Here's a view of the work on the launch tower cladding. A couple of Raptor engines were seen move to the launch site. A test article was placed on the structural test stand. Work has continued on Ship 24 atop Pad B. Here's a view of Ship 25 and the Ship 26 nose cone in the high bay. On the left is the Ship 28 nose and on the right is the Ship 29 nose. Booster 7 was recently lifted off of the orbital launch mount. Mary posted this picture on Twitter of Booster 7 being rolled back to the production site. Booster 9 continues to be worked on in the Mega Bay. As always, I have to say thanks to Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.